Hi, I'm Chase.
And I'm Morgan, and we're here at the University of Alabama in the Bevel Building, and we're going to show you the fine art of polishing and grinding down some samples.
So let's begin.
Too loud!
So here we are in the depths of Bevel with all of the grinding and polishing machines behind me. Now, they're actually very simple machines, and will be explained in more depth and detail later on. Now, they work very similar to a potter's wheel. They'll be spinning really fast, except we'll have sandpaper on top of them. So when you lower your specimen down onto it, you'll get to smooth out all of those scratches that are on the surface.
So let's begin. First, we'll take the plastic protective ring off of the grinder. Then, we'll take the metal holding ring off of the turntable, like so. You just put your finger in there and it'll pop right up. Next, find the appropriate grinding pad, which is normally starting with the roughest grit, which is usually the lowest number. Then, when you've selected the right grinding pad, take the adhesive backing off of the back of the pad, like so, and place it firmly onto the turntable, trying to center it in the middle of the turntable. When doing this, run your fingers along the outside of the pad, smoothing out any wrinkles or air bubbles that may exist. This could cause unnecessary scratching later on when you're grinding your specimen. Finally, take the metal holding ring, place it back onto the machine like so. This secures the grinding pad onto the turntable. Then take the plastic ring and place it back onto the machine like so. This will prevent splashing from the water. Next, to turn the machine on, find the big green button on the front of the machine, also known as the on button. It is located right here. Next, you're allowed to adjust the RPMs or the speed on the grinding turntable as you grind. It is located here. The higher the RPM, the faster it goes. The next step is adjusting the water flow. First, we'll turn the machine on so you can see it move. Before you start with the water flow, make sure that the valve in the back is turned on, or else you won't get any water flow from this valve. To get water flow from this valve, turn the valve to the left and open it up. You want a nice constant water flow, but not for it to be overpowering. Before you start grinding your sample, make sure that the entire grinding pad is completely saturated. And when you begin, let the water remain at a nice constant flow slash drizzle.
So here's a helpful hint before we start. Make sure that you hold your sample at a constant angle so that you get nice parallel lines from the sandpaper grid. It's a good way to know that once all of your big scratches are out, because you'll have all of those nice even lines together. And then when you switch later on to another grid, you're going to turn it 90 degrees. And that will also let you see when all of the old scratches are out, because you'll have new parallel lines and pretty much perpendicular to your old ones. So now let's begin.
Does your sample look nice and cylindrical from the side like this? Or does it look more like this? If it looks like this, you are applying entirely too much uneven pressure. Now's an important time to talk about lab safety. When grinding your specimen, make sure you have a firm grip on the specimen at all times. Also, wear your lab goggles.
Sorry about that, Chase. I love you.
When you're done grinding your sample with your current grit, you need to wash your sample before continuing on with the next grit. To do this, wash it with water and your average cotton swab. Scrub pretty thoroughly. Rinse your sample again. And then blow it dry with air, which is found in the hood. And then you can move on to your next grit. Now you're ready to change sandpaper grit. When changing sandpaper grit, you will escalate in value from the roughest grit to the finer grit, going from the lowest number to the highest number. So, if you started with 200, then you'll now move to 320 and so on, all the way up until the finest grit of 1200. When when swapping pads is exactly the same as applying a new pad. You'll remove the protective rings from the turntable, pull off the old dirty nasty pad, and replace it with your new grit paper in escalating value.
For polishing, it's pretty much the same as grinding. Find a polishing pad, which will be the same shape and everything for the round turntable, and it'll usually be a lighter color and a different feel to it than the sandpaper grit. Remove the adhesive backing, just like before, and center it and place it on the turntable, making sure to get out all air bubbles and that it's firmly in place. Take the metal holding ring and place it back on to secure it, as well as the plastic ring back on so that water doesn't come out at you. Next, you want to just initially wet the cloth. You don't want it to have a constant water flow the entire time that you're going. Turn on the machine and turn on the water, initially wetting the cloth. After you've set everything up, find your different suspensions. There'll be different micrometers, and it kind of works like the sandpaper. Each one will get finer and finer as it goes, and each suspension will slightly polish it to a finer and finer degree till you have a really reflective surface. This is why you don't have the water running, because you will wet the cloth with the suspension that you have. Put as much on as you think that you'll need, and you can always go back later and add some more. Usually you can tell this because the pad will start wearing or it'll kind of slip from your grip. So this is the exact same process as before. You take your material and you hold it down, making sure to have uniform pressure and that you're at a constant angle. And then you'll just go through each grit until you have a nice reflective surface. After you're done with this specific suspension, make sure that you wash it with water, just like before, to get all the suspension off of it. And then also, the same as grinding, you would wash or dry it off with air, just to make sure that you have all the scratches out that you were trying to get out from before. Now, it's exactly the same as before. When you switch your different suspensions, you need to change your pad because each suspension is finer and finer, so you don't need the rougher suspension there to create bigger scratches. So you will remove the plastic ring, the metal holding ring, and the pad, and get a new polishing pad as well as your new suspension, making sure that you know which one that you were on so that you can consecutively go down and do finer and finer numbers.
Well, I feel like we've had a successful day.
Yeah! Well, aside from that little trip to the Student Health Center and all, sorry about that again.
Yeah. Anyways, we hope that this video has helped you in your quest to become a better grinder. To the lounge!
Well, wait a minute. Yeah. Okay, yeah, this way. Yeah.